and welcome to another episode of I Demand a Homestead. My name is Amanda, and today what we're going to do is we're finally getting around to bottling our mead. We had another couple of episodes on how we kind of started with some wax honeycomb that was left over from our honey extraction, and then how we kind of soaked that in water to then extract this honey water, which we then added some spices to and fermented to make mead. Now, this has been sitting for several months now, and it's finished fermenting. It takes a while, and now it's ready for bottling. So the things that you're going to need if you're going to be bottling your own mead, first of all, we're going to use 1 liter swing top bottles, okay? So you could put use wine bottles with corks. The other thing you're going to need, we are first going to siphon this into a clean and sterilized fermenting bucket. And then we have a section of kind of tubing that we'll use to siphon it out. And lastly, the thing that we need is a bottling wand. So this, if I can bring it close enough to you, it's just a length of tubing, but it has this little kind of depressor here that actually, when you let it go like this, it stops the flow of the mead or the wine or whatever you're bottling. And then when you depress it like this, it actually starts it flowing. So that way you can move from one bottle to the next and it will stop and you won't kind of drip. All right. So the first thing we're gonna do in this process is we're going to siphon this from this carboy into our fermenting bucket so that way I can make sure that we don't get any of the sediment at the bottom. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is we're going to take the one end of our siphon hose. We're going to take off the airlock here, that down, put this in here, making sure we don't disturb the sediment at the bottom, okay? And then we have to create a suction. So we basically just kind of suck on the end of this hose until it fills all the way up, okay? And now that we have this full of the mead and there is no air in this hose, then we're going to put it down to the bucket, which is underneath, so that the siphon will work. It does need to be at a lower level, otherwise it will not siphon. You can see that is draining into the bucket. Okay, so we're gonna keep siphoning that until this is all empty. All right, so here is our beautiful clear mead. It's a darker color than some meads you might have had because again, this was used kind of beeswax comb. And so it wasn't kind of pure, clean, filtered honey, which would give you a lighter colored mead. But I like the flavor of this. I think it's got a little bit kind of more wildness to it, maybe a little bit more taste of the beehive, if you will. All right, so now what we're going to do is I have attached my bottling wand to our siphon tube. I'm going to create that suction again, and then we're going to start bottling. Okay, so here's my bottle. I've kept these kind of closed so that way they stay sterile. Open this up, I put the wand in here, and then it's gonna start to fill up. It's a bit hard with these dark bottles to kind of see exactly where the level is, but I can kind of tell. And I've already filled up this one, and then all you do is you just snap it down and then close it up like that. And then we'll just go and fill up all the bottles. And we'll come back when they're all done. And there are our 23 beautiful 1 liter bottles of mead. Okay, so here is the moment that Dave has been waiting for months. If you've been watching the first video, back when it was snowing,
yeah,
he ran crazy through the snow as a Viking.
I know.
And here we are.
Mead. Well, this is good. This is really good. You can really taste the honey as well as a little bit of the beeswax kind of part of it, right? So it's quite nice.
Mm-hmm.
I like this. So let me ask you a question.
Mm.
Now that you've made the mead, do you think we should get the cow horn cups to go with it like the Vikings did?
Oh, I'd love that. That'd be cool.
Okay, so let's do that.
All right.
Do you want me to close it or do you want to close it?
Go for it.
All right, and on behalf of I Demand a Homestead, if you like this video, please click the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. And hope that you kind of enjoyed Amanda in the process in terms of making mead. We're going to sign off now and probably enjoy a little bit of the mead. As always, please drink responsibly. And we'll see you next time on the I Demand a Homestead.
All right.
Cheers.
Cheers.